Hello all. This video I have made primarily to help and benefit all the Amazon sellers who are using Indiapost as their shipping carrier. As I have been using Indiapost for the last 3 years, Indiapost has also evolved. As the time and the technology has evolved, Indiapost has also evolved. So, reading messages on our seller groups that this challenge is being faced by everybody. Yes, I know Indiapost, to an extent, yes, chasing Indiapost is a challenge. But being a national carrier, yes, they do take responsibility. In my case, particularly if I say, my 99% of the cases have been resolved within the timelines. Yes, there are 1% cases which, yes, did got resolved, but after a certain period of time where we might have to face the brunt of the customer, I might have to refund the money and the customer has later on received the product also, but that's only 1%. So if we are receiving, if we are getting a complaint from the customer on time and we take a quick action on it, definitely things are easier. So without wasting a time, let's get started to the new process launched by Post. This process was launched by Indiapost, I believe, when they were migrating the new data. So it's been around 4 to 5 months of me using this new structure, and the results are actually excellent. I must praise Indiapost and the government of India in getting such an initiative. So I have made this video as a slide presentation to guide you through this entire process. So let's get started. So yes, this is the URL. Now how I got this URL, because as I said, I'm using Indiapost very actively. I'm an e-com seller. You are also e-com seller if you're watching this video as an e-com seller. So my mode of communication with Indiapost was Twitter. If it is not getting resolved even through Twitter, I used to write a mail to the secretary post and get the resolution done. And one fine day I got in touch with the social media team handling this entire escalation process, and they said, sir, we have recently launched a new platform to cater to our particular all these kind of requirements, and in fact this is the same tool which we also use. So what we are doing, we are passing this tool to you. You please raise a direct complaint to get a quicker resolution. Even if you send to a Twitter, we will of course use this tool again to direct a complaint. This complaint will go, we'll get a number, and then the follow-up will get started. So what happened? This is the new URL by Indiapost. So you have to put this URL, https://indiaposttracking.onedirect.in. This is the URL and how it opens consignment tracking request form. I'll just open this URL for you on the actual browser. So this is the form which will open if you enter this URL, right? This has the Indiapost logo to it and consignment tracking request form. Name, you have to fill your name or your organization name. Give a email ID on which they can communicate with you. Give a mobile number in case they want to call you. In the description field, this is also evolved over a period of time. So for you, it's a quick tip. In the description field, write, item has not reached. Whatever you want. If you want a POD, write, we want a POD. So you write, item has not reached. Consignment number is CD, ED, EM, whatever the consignment number is. And then write the full address of the recipient. Like this. I'll just fill it for you. Item not delivered. Consignment number is CD12, whatever number is, IN. Recipient, I'll not write recipient, I'll write consignee details. So say he is Ramesh Singh, C922, Balagur, Maharashtra, whatever. Just put a fictitious name on this and the pin code. And most important, contact number of the consignee. Give this much detail in this particular box. This box has a lot of space to it. Then consignment number, just try the consignment number here. Source pin code is your pin code. Like in my case, my source pin code That is, I reside in this pin code. 110850 is my pin code. Destination pin code, wherever you are sending your product, so it could be 701, 601, whatever, you just have to type here and say add. The moment you add, there's a pop-up which will come to you as a ticket number. The moment you add here, it'll give you a window saying success, your complaint number is this. Note down that complaint number, because this complaint number you will not get again from India Post. There is no way you can complain, you can track this particular complaint by the complaint number. But if you have this complaint number, you can alternatively reach to them through a Facebook and Twitter also. Now what will happen once you raise a ticket number? Just we'll come back to our slide. This one. So here, yeah. So we have, what we have done, we have input all the data to it. A ticket number has come, we have noted down the ticket number. That's the most important step. Don't negate, note down the complaint number. Else you will be in a trouble. Amazon will ask you the ticket number, you will not have the ticket number with you. Then what will happen? Once all the detail entered, the ticket number gets generated. As I told you, I have taken taken example of two Amazon customers. I've taken an order number. Mr. Tara Janvarigo is written to us. I have raised a complaint. First step is auto-generated email vendor. Now, as the moment I generate a ticket number, next morning, it will not happen immediately. Suppose I have raised a ticket number at 6 o'clock in the evening or 5 o'clock in the evening. Immediately, this will not happen. But the next morning, at 10 or 11 o'clock, you will get an auto-generated email like this by the ID called Directorate Central Desk. This is social media, indiapost@gmail.com via one direct in. That's the platform they use. So social media, indiapost@gmail.com, the ID comes at Directorate Central Desk. It says, sir, ma'am, your grievance is on top priority, forward it to concerned circle, we will revert you soon. So what they have done, auto-respond has come up to you, ticket is already generated. Now this is forwarded to the respective circle. You have given the pin code, you remember the ticket, you have given a pin code. So based on that pin code, it is given to the respective circle. What will happen next? Now the respective circle will take over. In this particular case, CPMG Haryana, that is Chief Postmaster General Haryana's ID, CPMG_HRY@indiapost.gov.in. Via one direct in, they have replied that, sir, article was sent, returned to sender due to shop was closed for many days, inconvenience caused, deeply regretted. So I know the status, I got the status, my ticket is now closed. Easy? Very easy. Effective? Yes, 100% effective. But I said 99% because yes, 1% of the cases takes time to respond, and sometimes we lose the battle in between because customer is mentally impatient in this case. So let's come to the next case. So tracking on India Post, as this is an out of a ticket, and this is generated out of a ticket, it is not mandated that India Post will update the status. At the rate of completion of tracking for all the cases, practically is never 100%. As you have noticed, even if you received the packet, India Post in many cases have not updated that record due to many reasons they have. But these tickets are enough as they were independently get resolved early. Yes, these are early resolution ones. We get emails from India Post circle or division confirming the closure of raise, case raised at any given point in time. Let's take a sample study case number 2. This is an order number. Again, a ticket was raised. Same sequence will happen in this case also. What happened? Anyway, this is a long follow-up with this case because there was an A to Z guarantee involved in this particular case. This is my first autoresponder mail I received from, again, Directorate Central Desk. You see the ID. This is the one ID you will receive. Again, it's on top priority and it will be resolved. I have escalated this manually because I had an A to Z claim at that time. That's a separate thing. I can do that. Now, this was a revert on a manual escalation. Chalo, leave this also. This is my first response on the ticket from the Postmaster General of NKRO region. Replied, sir, the article is received at Hubli NPH on 22nd of February 2019. Further dispatched to Huzapet SPH on the same day. Now the bag containing the article is in the transit. Please wait. This is the response, and then see the bottom is this my ticket. If you see, this is in bottom. This is the information which I gave to India Post at the time of logging the ticket, if you remember. In the description box, what I filled? I filled the consignment number. I said consignment has not reached the consignee, consignee details, blah 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 blah, phone number, this. So the box, the details are very important if you want an early resolution. That's one thing you have to follow that. And next thing, ticket closed. After 4 days of that particular last email, ticket closed again by PMG, NKR, same mail replied back. Sir, the article has been delivered on 25th of February 2019. That's it, done. So my ticket of 12th of February got closed on 25th of February. My article reached on 25th of February. My complaint was generated on 12th. I received an autoresponder on 13th. The first reply came on 21st, when actually the packet was traced and it was on the way, transit, everything was settled. Because it sometimes it takes time, yes, because India Post also takes time. Where is it exactly? If it is not in the tracking system, I'm not able to trace, you are not able to trace, then only India Post has to go back to the first and the destination in between origin, all cases, where is the packet right now. So in this particular way, this was a Karnataka packet, was traced back to Kerala, and from Kerala it was shifted to Karnataka and item was delivered to the customer. Ticket was successfully closed. Tracking does not matter here, as closure is on email. So that's about it. That's what you need to do. Save the URL, one, save it, I've saved it as a favorite. Fill all the relevant details in the ticket. In the box is very important. Box should have the consignee name, consignee address, consignee phone number, and your consignment number. Other than this, the mandatory fields are there. Ticket, pin code origin, pin code closure, your email, everything. Just fill up. Note down the ticket number, because you will not be able to find this ticket number anywhere in the India Post system easily. So note that out, and we are done. Thanks for watching. Any questions, please write as a comment. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you guys, bye bye.